This video is about putting filter threads on the front of this little camera. This is an Aiptek H5 Extreme, and like most small cameras, it doesn't come with any threads on the front for filters or accessories. And the way I did it was like this. I took calipers and measured the outside of the lens barrel and found it to be 45 millimeters. The next available size for filters and accessories is 46, so I ordered this 46 millimeter female coupling adapter. It's a Sonya, and they call it Female Coupling Adapter 46mm from camerafilters.com, $5. And then I used an 1/8 inch wide strip of this heavy-duty clear packing tape. Three turns ended up being just right, and force-threaded this 46mm female ring onto it. And in the process, I used the caliper's depth gauge to measure around at 4 points and adjust it as I went to get it on there straight. And I got it within about 0.02 of an inch of being on there perfectly straight. Now, this is very tight. If you really try to twist it, you can, but it's not going anywhere. And I meant to put it on and leave it more or less permanently. Once you do put a female coupling adapter on the outside of the barrel, it'll probably interfere with your lens cap, so you'll just want to put a UV filter on there and leave it and not worry about your lens cap anymore. I also bought the Zykosh 3 filter set that's widely available online for about $10. And it has a polarizer and this UV filter and a fluorescent filter. And I also got this neat Minon DVS lens hood to keep the sunlight out of your lens, and it comes with a white lens cover and a black one. The white one's good for white balancing your camera, and I'll show you what that looks like on the camera. I've got the polarizer on the back of it. Indeed, with this hood on there, it's large enough that even at minimum zoom with a polarizer behind it, I can turn the polarizer and the hood, and it still won't get into the frame of the picture. I also got this 58 millimeter wide angle lens. Actually, I ordered a 46 and it comes in 58 and they send an adapter for it. It doesn't obstruct any of the lens because the back lens on the wide angle is actually 46. And as you can see, when you put the step down ring on there, it doesn't obstruct any of the lens. And I can put that right on the front of the camera and now have a 0.45x wide angle lens. It is large enough to obstruct the flash, but I'd be using it outdoors anyway, so not to worry. So that's how I did it. If you want to put an adapter ring on your camera, just measure the barrel, get something that's within 1 millimeter larger and find a way to put it on there. But this was simple. It works. It's good and tight, and it's nice and clean. I cut the tape so narrow that after threading the ring on, there's none sticking out anywhere, and it just basically looks like it's made that way. Took some pictures outside, and we'll look at those in a minute. But first, I'd like to say thank you for watching my videos. Please subscribe, and you can see an article about this conversion with some notes on how I put the ring on there, measured it and everything, and some photographs on my website at kv5r.com. So let's go outside now and take a look where I play around with these accessories a little bit. Thanks for watching.
Okay, I'll be testing some filters. And this is the Aiptek H5 Extreme. I'm in 1080p mode, but first I want to see what a UV filter really does. There's the UV filter, and there's off, and there's on, and there's off, and there's on. I can't see any difference in the little monitor. Polarizer on top of that. That way we get trees, clouds, and sky. Yeah, there's where the sky is bright. And at that point, it's darker and the trees are greener. Note that when using a polarizer, it needs to be at a different angle depending on where the sun is. I'm going to put on the Minon DVS 46mm hood. It looks like this, little rectangular hood. It's large enough on this camera that I can rotate it. As you can see, I'm screwing it in, and at any angle, it's not interfering with the lens. That's handy because you can put it on the polarizer and turn the polarizer and the hood without it getting in the picture. Now that should be looking at the sun right there. Now we'll come away from it. Well, I don't think it really does a lot. Now I'll be testing the Digital Concepts digital high definition 0.45x super wide angle lens width macro. It's called 45, but we've proven it's actually 0.75 unless you take the rear element out of it. That much. See the tree on the left? Not really a lot of difference. Now I'll go in and remove the rear element and make it a 45. Now I've returned with the wide angle lens with the rear element removed. Note that you can't just unscrew the macro portion and then screw that on, because they stupidly made the front of this male and the back of this female. If they'd done it the other way, you could just screw this onto your adapter ring and get it much closer. So basically I'm using the macro portion as a male-to-male adapter, and I've taken out the glass element. So that's what it looks like with just the front element. And on my website, I have photos of a tape measure where I set the camera up, pointed down at the floor, laid a tape measure on it. And with just the camera, I measured 24 inches. With both elements of this lens, I measured 33, which is 0.75. And with the rear one removed, I measured 57 inches, which is about 0.44. There's a vast difference. You see that nearest tree in the left edge of the frame moves way in. That's a vast difference. I would suggest, if you're not going to use this thing for macro work at all, just take the rear element out and it will be a 45, like it says it is, instead of a 75, which is pretty much useless. There you see that much. Okay, look at the little storage building through the trees there. Looks like it's more than twice as far away. But at this resolution, I'm not seeing anything in the corners there. You don't want to stack any filters behind this, because when you move it out, you will get a dark area in the corners. Which I'll put back on behind a polarizer right now. And with it sitting out there at a little extra distance, you can see the corners. See, it's sitting out about 6 millimeters further than it was, and now you're starting to see the corners of the lens. So that's what that looks like. It works. for close-up stuff, as you'll see in the pictures on my website, it's not suitable because you'll have everything will be blurry all around the edges. But for this distance stuff outdoors, it makes a pretty decent, almost a fisheye. So there you go, end of test. Please visit my website, kv5r.com. Look for the camera stabilizer item on the menu, and there's a bunch of articles in there that are constantly growing, and now not just about camera stabilizers, but I have a review of the Aiptek H5 Extreme camera in there, and a review with photographs of these filters and this lens, and an article on how I put the 46mm filter threads on the barrel of this camera. So hope to see you there, and subscribe to my videos. Thanks for watching.